made with the kappa sheep was reduced from 19 to 16. We applaud you for that. All the reductions you've made, we applaud you. And to me, that is the essence for which the people of this nation should have benefited more from electricity than ever before. But it will surprise you, Mr. Speaker, honorable members, to note that in the midst of all of these savings, the cost of electricity was tripled.
Yes.
Was tripled. There was 300% increase in the cost of electricity.
Yes.
Yes. Previously, it was 590 leos. Now it is 627 kilowatts per hour for household, and for businesses it is 2,017 kilowatts for businesses. So it has been tripled, 300% increase. So you ask yourself the question, why do you save and still increase the burden on the people of this nation? What is the essence of saving? And let me tell you, it will interest you to note that the revenue of EDSA, or the electricity sector of this country, was previously about 32 billion euros a month. But now, it has gone up to previously it was 22 billion euros a month. But now it has gone up to over 32 billion euros a month. More revenue, more cost on the people, no electricity. So the equation is baffling. It's baffling. Mr. Speaker, I was in Mungi for the past 1 week. There was no electricity. What I did was to move my generator from Freetown to Lungi. And my generator, I left my generator in Lungi. I was in Freetown yesterday. My wife and I were working on a project. And there was no electricity. When I went to put my generator, I forgot that I left it in Lungi. So you begin to ask yourself, what is the essence of these savings? Who is benefiting?
The minister.
I was astonished. I was totally flabbergasted. I was amazed. I was freezed. When I saw the minister donating generator, then I know we are not prepared yet. I know we are not prepared yet. If we are anticipating the supply of electricity in the shortest possible time, there was no need for the donation of generator. When I saw that, I told my wife that, please, this money that we have kept for our project, let us use it to buy the generator. The minister has sent a very loud signal that our country is not in a short while prepared for sustainable electricity. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, I am from Lungi. I am the member of parliament from Lungi. And I spend most of my time in Lungi than any other place. It will interest you to note that in Lungi, for the recent 2 months, there was no electricity. For the recent 2 months, there was no electricity. And interestingly, for the past two weeks, electricity will be supplied once per week. Once per week. And let me tell you what the problem is. With all the savings, with all the increment in tariff, there was no money to buy fuel.
Right.
Elungi, the infrastructure is there. The infrastructure is there, but there is no money to buy fuel. Yes. In fact, there was 21,000 liters that was sent there recently. And that 21,000 liters, if it is used to supply electricity for 12 hours a day, it will only serve Lungi for 4 days. After the 4 days, we go again as usual.
Wow. So even for the blood generator.
My colleagues over there are saying people steal electricity. That is the weakest of excuses I've ever had. They have stolen electricity since the Pope was an altar boy.
Exactly.
All governments have suffered from that, but no government has made it an excuse not to supply electricity. No government. And these are the basic necessity for the development of any nation. So if our external results in public examinations are poor, ask whether the kids had electricity to study.